Today I will explain how to post one supplier invoice with reference to multiple orders in SAP S4HANA using SAP GUI and SAP FIORI. To post a supplier invoice with reference to a purchase order, we use transaction MIRO. I already explained how to use this transaction with reference to one purchase order. I will leave you a link to the video here so you can check it. And today I'm going to focus only on how we can do the same for multiple purchase orders. So I will start by inserting the invoice date. Then what we did before is we inserted the purchase order number here. Now, what if we have more than one purchase order assigned to the same invoice? So the invoice is something we receive from our supplier. If we have one supplier that has multiple purchase orders, maybe the supplier will send us one invoice that includes multiple purchase orders. How can we do this in this screen? So there are two solutions. The first one is you can click here and insert multiple purchase orders as you want. And then SAP will show you all the line items here. The other solution is you can ask SAP to display all the supplier items that are open. Let me show you this. So I will cancel. And instead of purchase order scheduling agreement, I will click and I will choose supplier. And then insert the supplier number here. So AG01 and enter. Then we get to the selection screen. So here we can choose whether we want to display the goods and service items, planned delivery costs, or both of them. And then we choose whether we want to see deliveries and returns or also both of them. In my case, I only want to see deliveries, so I will check only deliveries. And then we can also choose a plant. If we don't choose any plants, SAP is going to display all the open purchase orders for this supplier in all the company codes and in all the plants. In my example today, I'm going to mention my plant, AG10, and then click on adopt. Now SAP is displaying all the items of the purchase orders that are open in this plant. And as you see, there are some line items that are selected already and the others that are not. So the items that are not selected are the items that are closed. So either we received and invoiced all the quantity like this one. So we received 30 and we invoiced 30. So there's nothing else to invoice, or we did not receive anything and we did not invoice anything, so it is still not open. Still, if I want to add any value for this line, I can choose it manually. Now, SAP already selected all the line items that have open values, and then you can choose what lines you want to invoice. So I start by deselecting all the line items here. So now nothing is selected, and as you see, the balance of the document is zero. So if I try to post now, nothing will happen. As long as we don't select any items, nothing will be posted. Then I will select the items that I want to invoice. So for example, let's say this one, this one, and let's go down a little and let's take this one. Now, once I'm done selecting, if I hit enter, SAP will show the total value of the line items I selected, 870. So any item that's not selected, SAP is going to ignore. What we can do to make this easier is click on the refresh button here. So if you click on refresh, SAP removed all the items that we did not select. So now we can see what are the items we selected. And also you can change the layout here. So now I'm displaying a layout called PO history. This is a standard SAP layout. You can also choose other layouts here. So for example, all information. So this is up to you. You can display any layout you want to show the information you want to see. And I will go back to PO history. Now that I selected the items I want, I will continue with the rest of the documents. So the total amount is 870. And then we continue the same as if we are doing an invoice for one PO. It is the same data. So we go to payment, we can choose the baseline date, the payment term, and so on. Once we are done, we can go to post. And this is it, the document has been posted. Now let's see how we can do the same process in SAP FIORI. To open SAP FIORI, we have two options. We either insert the website address in the browser, or we can insert the transaction code in SAP GUI to open SAP FIORI. The transaction code is /n/UI2/FLP. Enter. The tile we are going to use to post a supplier invoice with reference to a purchase order is this one, Create Supplier Invoice Advanced. Click here. And this works exactly the same way like SAP GUI. So we start by inserting the company code, AG01. And then we insert the date. And again, we do the same. So we either choose purchase order, and we can insert multiple orders by clicking here. or we can select supplier and we insert the supplier code AG01, hit enter. And this is exactly the same also. So my plant is AG10, enter, and click on adopt. To see the line items in more details, we can close the header details. So click here. I will deselect all the line items by clicking here. And then I will select the line items I want. So for example, let's say this one, and this one. And also click on refresh so you can only see the ones you selected. And you can change the layout also same as SAP GUI from here. Once you are done, you can open the header again. Insert the total amount, 450. Insert the rest of the details, tax code, go to payment, the baseline date, payment term, payment method, and so on. Once you are done, you can click on post. And the supplier invoice has been posted. I hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, leave me your comments, share the video, and I will see you again soon. Thank you for watching.